Yeah, Ars Electronica is on the one side a very traditional festival for media arts in 34 years. It's called the Festival for Art, Technology and Society. And based on this dedication to think about the cultural and social impact of new technologies, we also created a permanent exhibition and education space, which is the Ars Electronica Center, where we do exhibitions about a broad range of topics, how new technologies are creating an impact on our life, how they change our social structures, how they change our cultural behaviors. And we are especially using interactive technologies, immersive visual scenarios and this kind of things to create a space of experience for our visitors where they can really have a kind of one-to-one encounter with the technologies of today to get a glimpse of how this will develop into the future maybe.
Okay, and so there is a future museum now, so it's open the whole year, it's not any longer a festival. Yeah.
So the museum was created in 1996. We have meanwhile a much larger building than 96. So since 2009, we have about 6,500 square meters. We are doing exhibitions from issues like the social media and the whole questions of public and private. We have big exhibits about life sciences. Just at the moment, we run an exhibition about synthetic biology. So it's really this broad range. There's always technology and science, the kind of core of the topic, but it's not a museum like a science center where we try to explain how technology is working. We try to find out and to explain what it means if we have these technologies becoming an increasing part of our life, whether it's the computer, the internet, the mobile phones, or robotics, or even more in the field of biotechnology and life sciences. We are facing these challenges that technology is invading, so to say, our life and our culture. And how can we respond to it? How can we, remain in charge of it, in control of it? How can we avoid to be just consumers of technologies? How can we become creators of applications? These are the things that we are concerned. We have a strong educational activity with this. So there is a lot of workshops, laboratories, in particular, of course, for the young people, for the schools. So we understand ourselves also as a kind of complementary educational measurement that is collaborating very strongly with the school system.
Okay. I must ask how you work with, how do you find these artists?
I think we have one major element in our organization, and this is the Prix Ars Electronica. It's a very large international award competition for computer art and digital culture. We have more than 4,000 submissions in the last years, every year, coming from almost really all over the world. And we have a large international jury that is looking through all these applications and submissions and selecting and extracting the best projects and best ideas. And this is, of course, a wonderful and unique resource to really be constantly included in this flow of ideas, new projects and new developments.
My last question will be, what do you see for trending next year, 2014?
Well, I think it's always difficult to talk about the future. This is predictions are always hard to make. But I think what for the coming years, the main important thing is when we look at this digital revolution, how it's often called, we, so to say, we have had the technical part of the digital revolution. So from the computer to the big mainframe, to the personal computer, now to our smartphones that we're wearing with us all the day. So the technical part is really has happened. But now we have to work on the cultural part. We, so to say, have to digest what it means to have all this technology permanently around us. And I think this is the really interesting moment, because we are now growing up a generation who is totally familiar with these technologies, who are no longer in awe and just, wow, how great is it to have a computer. A computer for them is as normal normal as a bicycle or a radio or whatsoever. And so these are all sort of the developments that focus on this point where the applications and what we really can do with how we can make use of this technology. This is becoming more and more important, and it is becoming a kind of competition between the pure commercial application and use of this technology and this big spirit that we still feel behind the technology, that it also can empower us, that it also can give the civil society a new position. And I think this is really the big challenge. It's like the kind of big fight now that this technology is really used in a way that we as a society can benefit and not just the big corporations can benefit from it.